I'm going to go to the hospital. Heal of the power with any elect office and I'll be paying for and the biggest office. But you currently, you're living fair, moral, social, moral, those who practice magic dance, the doctors and the others are faced with me in the very time of God. This is the second one. This is one of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
If you are blessed,
longevity. Then congratulations. Papa was 89. So that means he wasn't a kid. He wasn't a young man. Papa the Arubo will have been 90 by this year. And so, when somebody is blessed with longevity like Baba, I know that there is no way that one will not miss the aged ones. My members were looking at me in November, whether I will cry when I buried my father. He was just 83, and they were surprised to see their pastor crying. It is just natural, so I'm not going to be surprised. Even all Baba's children, you know, cry when Baba will be lowered into the mother heart. It is natural. No matter how old the person that is being buried is, there is a way that one will be missing him. You know, when we are living together, we build memories. You remember? I know that Mama is crying like this now. Not only because she will see her husband no more. I'm sure that Mama is having series of flashback to what they used to do when she was young, when Baba was chasing her around, when she started having her children, when they were training the children, when it was fine, when the going was fine, and when the going was a bit tough. When you are living with your spouse, every day you build memories. What you are doing today, in 10 years' time, if somebody should ask you, you will be able to give an account of how the movement of today is. So we build memories with everything we do every day. And that is part of what normally, what normally makes people to mourn whenever a dear one is gone. So it is natural. Once again, Mama, I may not have the opportunity to speak to you as far as the burial of your, the death of your husband is concerned. Mama, it is time to, yes, she's listening to me. I know her very well. I know Mama very well and intimately too. Mama, it is time to just accept what God has given to you. It is time to begin your relationship afresh with your God.
Kẹ̀sùn ẹ̀sìn tó máa tún sun sílé nìyẹn.
nígbà bá gbé bàbá tá a bá tẹ wọn lẹ ló gbọmọ sọ nígbà bá dọla tá a gbé bàbá sínú wò ẹ tún sùn sí ìgbé bá padà délé tẹ bá padà dékò tó bá kẹyìn nìkan báwọn ọmọ ti lọ gbé wọn ẹ tún domi jẹ ọ lójú o màmá àdúrà ó sì mọ gbà yóò mọ gbà lójoojúmọ àdúrà yìí lórí àwọn ọmọ yìí yóò mọ gbà ẹ mọ láyọ sí ni. The Bible has told us about heaven and where and hell. Jesus nikan olomo bi be sere and the testimonies of the Bible is what we are banking on about heaven and hell. And I thank God that even other religions, this Islamic religion and some other religions, all the religions that we have testified to the fact that we have two places after your own time, after my time has expired here on earth. And the first place is heaven. And we know Jesus told us that that place we call heaven is where his Father lives. And so he has, because he wouldn't want us, after all the wahala in this world, after the ups and downs, honestly speaking, there is no resting time in this world. I'm telling you, no matter how old you are, there is no resting time. If you say you want to rest, at times your mind might not be at rest. But you are at it that bad. At it to personally, I want more. No matter concerns for what, I will be one. Then you come back and then we end it, Mama. Oh, the job I grew. Oh, the job I grew. Oh, the job I grew. It's your papa. Se mo ni le Yoruba afere bi alawa we always want. My daughter was asking me in the years back that thing is like you have too many people, your family, your extended family, how is it that every one of you always look for one another? And I told her that is how we were born Yorubas and me a bi. So, nígbà tá a bá wà, tá a bá ṣì wà láyé, ọkàn wa nígbà mìíràn, ó lè má rí ìsinmi tó yẹ ká rò ó yẹ ká rí ìrò lọ́jọ́ alẹ́. Because of your people, the people around you, your children, your grandchildren, láti ẹ̀sọ́ wípé àṣìṣe máa ti fẹ̀yìntì. Iṣẹ́ àwọn ọmọ wa nígbà mìíràn, wọ́n máa jẹ wá gógó. Ìgbéyàwó wọn ó máa jẹ wá lógún. In the sun, in the rain, we want to come to church. We want to fast on their behalf. We want to do so many things to make sure that they are safe because of the love that we have for one another. So there is no permanent rest here on earth. Only ẹ̀yán lè sùn, kọ́kàn ẹ̀mọ́ sùn. Adam ọ̀pọ̀ máa ń ṣẹlẹ̀ wẹ́. You can close your eyes and you may think you are sleeping, but your mind may not be sleeping because your mind will be thinking of so many things. If there are problems, you want solutions to your problems. You wouldn't want the problem of yesterday to still continue tomorrow. You'll be looking for ways to have things solved for you and your household. Ask me, where is the rest? Here on earth. So that is why Jesus told us that in his Father's place, some Bible interpreted it to be rooms. Well, I don't know whether it is a room because I've not been there. The Bible says, in my Father's place, Jesus assured us that in his Father's place, as is Jesus, is the pillar of our faith. Whatever he tells us is If whatever it tells you is more reliable than whatever I, your pastor, will tell you. If only remember to mention Jesus one time. So, whatever Jesus says, I think is the final. He says that in his Father's house, in his Father's place, so Bible says there are many rooms. Well, if we are going to have rooms there, then that means we are going to be in the same house with our Lord Jesus Christ, with the Father, the owner of the house, you know, there living with us, or we will be living with him. Another version says, in my Father's house or in my Father's place, there are many mansions. That means it's going to be a very big compound. We are believers, we have their own mansions. What we know is this, whether rooms or mansions, all we believe is that we will be where our God is. We will be where Jesus is. And he has been preparing that place for us so that we don't lose that chance. A white throne. That's what the Bible says. A white throne. You see, Psalm 9, verse 7 has this to tell us, that the throne is prepared. The throne is being occupied by just one person. Not Jesus Christ this time around, but somebody that is bigger than Jesus is the owner of that throne. When you get home, you can look at it. And in Acts chapter 17, verse 31, you see, on that throne is somebody who has the power to welcome you. And when you are welcomed into that throne, you know, into that place where the throne is, you are going to receive something. You are going to experience something. And what me and you will experience when we get there is not just the welcome party. Yes, if we are able to do well here or not, the Bible says that the angels will rejoice and welcome us. Fantastic. But before the angels will rejoice at your coming, something must happen. Do you know what will happen before? It is the judgment. Hello, somebody. They're not here. Hello, somebody.
It's the judge.
I will receive my own judgment. Whether I have done well there or not, as a pastor, everything on the level of my life, from the beginning to the end, all the grace that I did not use well as a pastor, what I refuse to do, wherever or not, things of the world, everything will be opened before me. And if I have done well, I will receive that commendation. The commendation we are going to receive is greater than the commendation we have given to Baba. We are not going to travel with him to where he is right now to be his advocate. Never. We are not needed there. We are not needed. Who are those that will be judged? Who are those that will be condemned? Let me tell you, I always tell people that whatever we have in this world might not be enough for us to receive the credit. Maybe your act of benevolence, maybe your being very good to people. We have those who are caught in. And do you remember the story of talents? The 10 talents. The one that was given this, and that one that was given that amount of talent. And you have fought the good fight. And the crown that I mentioned yesterday, for those who are here, I told you that the crown over there is more beautiful than the crown that any king wears here on earth. The crown is made of gold. And those who have received their clean sheet bill will have their own portion of the crown. I pray that let's say all of us, those who will determined to start to do well as from today, will receive that crown of glory in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Some people, after receiving their judgment, they will be asked or they will show the way, whether to heaven or to hell. What happens in heaven? I've told you some of it yesterday. Heaven is the home of the winners. Those who have fought their race here on earth and they are there, they'll be there rejoicing and praising God because they are champions. And hell is the home of those who have enjoyed their lives in this place and have forfeited their eternal throne. What do they do in hell? All they do is to regret their action when on earth. You remember the story of Lazarus and the rich man? And the rich man who was given the grace to look after him and was doing what he liked. So they both departed from this simple world, and the rest of the story you all know. That is an assurance of heaven and hell. If somebody had told the rich man that this poor man is going to make heaven ahead of you, he will not believe it. Whoever wants to tell him that kind of a story. But he saw everything himself. He saw Lazarus, where Lazarus ended his life. So it is not possible for us to see where Baba is now, because the grace has not been given unto us. I know if the Lord is to open our eyes and we are to see where Baba is, maybe rejoicing and praising God with the angels, maybe somebody here may want to have a change of heart. Verse 16 is the home of the condemned. I don't know whether you have ever been to Kirikiri or any other prison. If you see where the condemned criminals are, honestly, you will have a change of heart. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
A boy was so notorious, but he didn't want to have anything to do with him. But you know, in those days, every stubborn child in the church will always be sent in to the vicarage. Because we believe that if that kind of a child is living in the vicarage, maybe there will be a kind of, a change in his life. But not maybe those were in those days. But even now, the devil is troubling us in the vicarage. The devil is battling with us. He doesn't want our children to make way in life. So, that this boy was very notorious. And the parents would cry to me almost every day. He would not stay in school. He was doing all sorts of trouble. And I was the vicar of the church. And I said, okay. I was not even convinced. I was afraid a bit for this kind of a notorious boy to become. And Mama said, Reverend, I want to leave him with you. So that maybe you will. And me and my party question, I said, right on back. Me, there's one no more. I have to agree. And the boy was living with us. Oh, for you, Mary, at a latter. Ha! If by me, I will not be able to sleep. Because I want to come out with pornography. Do bless him on the end. Our boys come out with the Our time, we were more than 25. It's a vicarage. So all the boys will be downstairs. One, be on the contact, go on, fair, what's okay. To party, what's okay, you'll be in trouble with me. If I don't worry more, hey, at this Sunday, Wahala. My team is so bad, but which is more than Jill and I will kill her tomorrow. And I will be praying. Timothy, Jill and you, Timothy, continue the hour where I'll be. I'm in a Bible study. I'm at Gratula. On your call, the Holy Spirit just told me, to take him to Kirikiri. And I called the director of the prison. Can you help me out? I want to visit Kirikiri. And he had the connection. One year, Yawale, let's go. Come. The driver, I tell me at home. Driver, you know, only bad maker. Very stubborn. Because if I told my dear, they told me they were like Kawale. And it is not in my habit to sack anybody. I don't like it. So I will make it. I'm a cola snowmoto. And take Kirikiri. What if my number is in my way? And we entered. And I asked the person, the officer in the prison, to take me to the condensed cell. That was where I took the two of them to. In a park, in motor, we are going together. And they just circled. And I took them to the condensed cell, and they saw things with their eyes. And I now had that idea at all. When he saw the condition of the condemned criminals, he saw a word, Tafidele, drive like an angel. He drove like an angel.
Do you know for 3 days, I didn't say a word to either the driver or the boy. And that was how God changed the life of his daughter.
When they saw the suffering of the condemned criminals, hear on earth, how will it be when the condemned will be in hell? Your behaviors now, what you are doing now, if you think it is not enough to condemn you, you better shame yourself. I pity you. You better have a change of heart now, because you don't know where you will end your life. If you have the grace to be put in a kind of box like this, then people will congratulate you. It's a honor, a big one, for us to die and people to gather and ask us to mourn us. It's a beautiful grace. So the hell is the home of the condemned. And when they get there, they'll be restless. I want to have a pain. You know what you do. I want to know we are guilty of the offenses. We are restless, and they want to be pardoned so that they can go out. Revelation 14, verse 12. And it is the place where people will gnash their teeth. Matthew 13, 41 and 42. Baba is no more. He has fought his own race. And he is before the Almighty God now. Take a lesson from what we are doing today and be determined of how you will use the rest of your life. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
You love them and you bless them. Father, bless them in the mighty name of Jesus. When the lifespan of Moses ended, you appointed a judge to appoint. That's why, after the Bible says, the Lord told them, I rolled away the path of the enemies from your life. So the Lord will roll away every plan of Satan concerning the family. This family will pray for you. The Lord will take you to the promised land. Amen. There shall be no itch. The enemy will not be able to stand against you. Amen. The power of the devil crawl before you in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray for the entire congregation as we pray the Lord for the not overcome you in the mighty name of Jesus. For he says, I created you and I created silver and gold. He shall become your servant. Silver and gold shall become a messenger
Amen.
God bless you.